Hey guys, welcome back to Hobby Jump. Today I'm going to show you how to make your very own vacuum chamber using a half gallon mason jar. You can find them readily available at most of your supermarket stores. Very fun and easy way to get into wood stabilization or science projects, anything of that nature. Let's head out to the shop and get started. These are the materials you're going to need to make this vacuum chamber: a drill, a couple of pieces of wood for drilling the lid, a 31/64 drill, a smaller drill for a pilot hole, solder, flux, a quarter inch NPT valve across, an inch and a half nipple, a quick disconnect for PEX, pliers, a torch, your half gallon mason jar, some water to cool off your part after you've soldered it, and then I'm using a 90 degree air grinder to clean the galvanizing off the lid. What we're going to do is we're going to drill a hole in the lid, and what I've done is I've cut a piece of wood in a square and put an X on it so that I have the center of the square piece of wood, and then I made it the same size as the recess in the top of the lid so that we'll know where the center of the lid is. When I did this the first time, I didn't use the top backing, and when you drill the hole with your 31/64 drill, a lot of the times you'll get like a tear out on the top. It'll actually peel the lid back like a can, and then it's a lot harder to solder. So we'll use the backing on both sides to prevent that from happening. We'll get it in the vise and drill the hole in it. Now we have our hole drilled. Makes a really pretty nice clean hole. We're gonna buff the paint off of it. The 31/64 hole should make your quarter inch NPT nipple thread into the hole. You want a really tight fit. We'll thread it in a little bit. Leave maybe an eighth of an inch hanging out on the back side. And then sit it down on a piece of wood to be able to solder it. Put some of this Stay Clean liquid flux on it. And then we'll get ready to solder it. You don't have to use Stay Clean liquid flux or silver solder. It's just what I had laying around. I'm sure any flux and solder will work doing this. And then when you go to solder it, I'm gonna direct the heat at just the fitting because the lid can't take very much heat. We'll get the fitting really warm and then get the solder to start flowing. And then once we get the solder flowing and I'm happy with the joint, we'll dip it in the water and solidify the joint. Now that we have our pipe threaded into our lid, we're going to make up our fittings. Put the threaded ring onto the lid before you do this, or else you won't get the threaded lid on. Now we have our lid assembly made. Let's try it out. I like to use these T's too, so that I can have more than one chamber If I'm doing any sort of wood stabilization and dyeing, you can do multiple colors at the same time. That will happen to do a separate process. Let's hook it up and try it out. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions or comments on how to make the chamber or what materials I used, there'll be a full list down in the comments below. Check out some of my other videos up here in this corner. Hit the subscribe button, the bell notification so you don't miss out on future videos. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day.